discuss their new album and their big Broadway debut. These guys next. Yes. You, the business behind media, entertainment, and pop culture. The operatic pop group Il Divo has sold over 26 million albums worldwide, and today their sixth album, A Musical Affair, hits stores. This is the group's first album of Broadway songs, so what better way to celebrate than to release a limited engagement of live concerts at the Marquee Theater right here in New York. This will mark the first time the four members will sing together on a Broadway stage. I'm joined right now by the singing sensation Il Divo, Urs Berler, Carlos Marin, Sebastian Izabard, and David Miller. Welcome, everyone, to Street Smart. Pretty exciting Broadway.
Good evening.
Absolutely. So tell me a little bit about the performance, what it's going to be like, David.
Well, as you said, we've just released our latest album, A Musical Affair, which is going to be all Broadway repertoire. Mm-hmm. And so we're putting together a show on Broadway that's going to showcase that album mm-hmm. and all of the other songs that we've done in our repertoire that have been featured in Broadway shows or in West End shows over the last few years. And just putting together a limited engagement to kind of debut the album and introduce it to the world.
Carlos, how did the four of you get your start?
That was a Simon Cowell's idea. He put us together. And then since then, I mean, we are together since 10 years. And now we put together this musical theater album because we thought that was a time to bring the musical theater again on stage with us, with our voices. So that's what we're doing.
And this is basically a classical style, Sebastian, for musical theater.
I don't know that I would call it a classical style, but what we do is we have a particular sound where we bring I'm a pop singer and my three friends are operatic singers, so we bring that style, you know, which is kind of our own stamp. Mm-hmm. It's not too classical, but it's a mix, and that's why the Broadway repertoire represents pretty well what we do, going from pop to opera.
It's like popera, you're saying. This is popera, right? You know, so you're kind of merging these two things. And it's interesting because there's a lot of people that say, opera, it's tough. I don't think I like this stuff. And you guys are basically bringing a genre, Urs, to a lot of people that might have been intimidated by it.
Yeah, we're trying to. And we always hope that this is the effect we have on the music consumer, because I always say that classical repertoire is incredibly rich and beautiful, but as you say, a lot of people kind of have that fear that it's going to be too cerebral, too complicated, I don't know enough about it. You don't have to. Just listen to all these popular classical tunes that are out there. A lot of people know them and they don't even realize it. You just have to enjoy music just like anything else. So just don't be scared of it. Go out there, listen to it.
Okay. Well, you guys have certainly shown them, right? I mean, 26 million albums you've sold. You've toured all over the world. So five performances you're going to do on Broadway?
It's going to be six.
Six performances.
7th, 8th, 9th, 11th, 12th, 13th. At the Marriott Marquis. And
it's exciting. Tell me a little bit about how you deal with this sort of changing industry. You were telling me earlier you've been together 10 years. We've obviously seen a tremendous shift with the onset of all these online music sites, Pandora, Spotify, iTunes, all of these things. How does that affect what you do?
I think it's obviously not a great thing, you know. I think it starts with education. I believe I'm a parent of three children, but I think it starts from there. You know, if you teach your kids that it's not the right thing to do, then I believe your children will grow with those values and will still want to buy CDs. I'm a big believer in that. I like to have an object. I like to have the photographs. But also, I think, you know, music, and I was talking about it to someone, you know, it reminds you just the song of a smell, of a date, of someone, of a friend, of a family. It is necessary in life. It's vital. Is that how you say that?
Vital. Yeah, vital. Yeah.
I'm French, forgive me.
Yeah.
But you know, you need that. So I don't think this will ever disappear. And I hope we'll remind our children and educate our kids that it is important to buy music.
You know, it's interesting because we're watching right now that the New York City Opera going through its bankruptcy there. When you look at traditional opera, it clearly continues to struggle with so many other choices out there. I mean, classical, as we were just saying, can be very intimidating. What is it about what you're doing that makes it different?
Well, I think that we we create a sense of what we've begun to call classical curiosity. Mm-hmm. As Urs was saying, you know, we kind of bridge that gap. It's not classical music that we're singing, but we're using our classical technique. And we're teaching people that you don't have to be afraid of the classical voice. It might be big and have a lot of vibrato and a lot of power, and it might move you emotionally and sometimes to a place that might feel uncomfortable. But that emotional discovery is, as Sebastian was saying, that's part of the musical journey, and that's part of what we need as humans to have this creativity. You know, we're one of the only countries in the world that doesn't have state-subsidized opera houses.
All right, this is one of my favorite songs, Conte Partiro. Sebastian, I hear you singing it now, the whole group. Do you think maybe this I can get a little bit of it from the four of you here?
A little bit.
You're catching us very much off guard there.
What do you think?
We do a little bit. Time.
You.
Okay. Time to say goodbye. Horizons are never far. If I live on this life with pride, I love you.
Excellent. Excellent. Thanks so much, guys. That's great. Hey, listen.
We have a good sound mixer on the
absolutely. Congratulations on the Broadway run. Have a great 6 performances, and thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
All right, the entire Il Divo group, Urs, Carlos, Sebastian, and David. Keep it right here. We got a little more Street Smart for you right after this break.